Hi, everyone. I'm going to be painting a very straightforward acrylic painting today. Now, the video may only last about 20 minutes. The reason for that is I'll be pausing a lot in between, so don't think that the painting will only take 20 minutes. So, first of all, I'll tell you what colours you should need. White, which is the most important, always use white for, obviously I used it for mixing colours, lightening and colours, things like that. We need some blue, we need some red, and also we need some yellow. Now as far as brushes go, one like this, just for painting on big areas. One like this for smaller areas. Now you'll see the difference in the size when we hold them side by side. There's quite a bit of a difference. And we've got one of these brushes here that I use. This is quite a hard bristled brush, this, compared to the rest of them, which are very soft. But the reason I use this one is because of the gaps up here. It's good for a certain technique. So that'll come in later on. You'll see what I mean later on in the video why this one's quite important. Now, if you don't have one like this, sometimes if you've got an old brush that's been well used, it kind of goes kind of bristly anyway, kind of spaced out, and you could use one of them. So first of all, we'll get your masking tape on. Now, this is optional, this wee border here. I always think it just adds a wee bit of quality to it once the finished painting. It's nice when you get that white border around it. Now, this piece of masking tape here, if you have the top half, this is really thick, this masking tape. Just use standard stuff. This is almost a wicked get at the minute. But I would just use normal thickness usually. Now, if you get the top of your masking tape about halfway up the canvas, then just use your own judgment and put it at an angle going up the way. And what we're going to do is paint the whole white whole top of this above the masking tape completely white. Now you're probably wondering why I want to paint white on a white canvas. It's just so when we put the blue down for the sky, that it's going to become a lot lighter when the blue starts mixing with the white paint that's already down. So it's important to get it down quite quick before it dries. So if you get the white on, so you get it on as fast as possible so that it's not getting a drying time. So then when we mix our blue, it's still nice and wet and it's a nice easy blend. Now, don't worry if you're not sure about anything, because once I post the video online, you're not sure anything, you can just leave your comments or whatever, and they'll get back to you if there's anything you're not understanding. The thing we're going to do is get some blue. Now, you don't need a lot of this blue. I've just got this wee bit, I've only been cleaning my brush in fact because it's going to be mixing with the white anyway, so just a wee bit on the tip here. You want to spread this out well across the top of the canvas above the masking tape. And what will happen is it will get lighter and lighter the more you work into it. Because it will just start reacting with the white then. It starts off quite dark up there where I put it down initially, then it'll just start. The more you brush in there, the lighter it becomes. Now, when I'm doing this guy, I tend to just paint left to right or right to left. I'm not wanting kind of brush strokes going up and down the way. Just here, I'm kind of doing that, just taking a flat in my masking tape a wee bit. But then I would start brushing over again at the horizontal. And the secret to this is just keep on, even if you think that your paintbrush isn't doing anything, just keep on working into it left to right, left to right, and do that for a good few minutes. Yeah, so you might not think it's doing anything, but it is. And you can see it's a lot lighter. It's a bit lighter over this side than it is over here, but that doesn't matter. It's a nice kind of sky look, and that's what we're looking for. So the next stage is take that middle piece of masking tape off. Now, what we're going to do is raise it up a notch, the masking tape, so that it's actually covering the sky that we've just done. But obviously you have to wait till that dries first. So as I said, we'll move this piece of masking tape up. Next thing we want to do is get some red. We'll use the same brush again, just to give it a wee wipe. We're going to be bringing red to about halfway here. Maybe down to about here. And this will... Now this doesn't have to be pure accurate, you know, it's just kind of brush strokes, it's not like solid colours. That's the canvas are showing through, that's fine. We're kind of looking for that effect. Then the other side, we're going to have some blue. And again, you don't have to be too particular about putting the blue on. As long as it's good down to about this level, that's that should be fine. So the next colour we're going to be using is this yellow I've got out here. And as you can see, my masking tape again is going to be very great. But we'll just go with it just now. Now we're going to start putting yellow. It's quite bold down the middle here. And just don't keep on topping up your brush, because it's not, we're not wanting pure yellow. Let's see, that's gradually turning into an orange. Just put a wee bit on at a time. What you want is, you see here is a gradual change from, you can see the green coming in there, then it's yellow, then it's turning into an orange, and gradually to the red. If we just keep on putting the yellow out to the left hand side, that green, it will become green and back to blue again, just do it the same way. Here, your brush will be wipe, you see the green starting to come through then. sometimes you just have to take a wee bit of yellow off your brush, just because you're putting it on, it's getting nowhere. It's just because there's too much on the brush. So just give your brush a wee wipe every now and again. I thought the next part is going to be this brush. Now you see what I mean, what I was trying to explain earlier on at the start of the video. Now, you can see how much paint's on that. It's very, very little. You see how it has kind of wee gaps in it. Now what I want to do, I start very, very lightly, just bringing wee white lines down here. There's a wee, just a kind of wee curve at the top, so slightly to the left and down. And it's very, very lightly you're going to put these lines in. So I've actually got a hairdryer on these colours here just to try them before I put the white on. I wasn't taking too great to where it was still, the paint was still a bit damp. Very, very lightly we're putting these brush strokes on, just barely touching the canvas. Now as you can see, it's a bit ragged here up at the top, that's just a pure masking tape, but if you've got good quality stuff, that'll not be a problem. So the next step is I'm going to be putting some clouds in. So I'm hoping that I can maybe disguise these marks here with clouds. So I'm just going to start off here and get a bit of white in. Now for your clouds, just forget about that last brush stroke I done, so that's, hopefully you don't have to do that. That's just for later on, so it's a wee bit lighter when I do go to cover it. Right, now for your clouds, I find the best way to do your clouds is start from your kind of highest up one, so say about here, and just get a wee outline shape. Now you're wanting the edge of the cloud to be quite bold. Now give your brush a wipe so it's dry once you've got this bit in and start dragging it down. You see it starting to fade. You see me circular motions like that and you see it starting to fade, and that's what we're about to do. And what then is we can start over again here. Again, just get your brush a wipe and just kind of and that looks quite effective clouds. And you just keep on repeating this process until you're happy with the amount of clouds that you actually have in the sky. So I'm going to try and cover this wee bit of red here. So I'm just giving my brush a wipe again after that, because it's on quite thick there, just so that it does cover that red. And I'm just going to dab it in here. I'm going to pause the video just now, and I'll restart it again once I've got a bit more clouds in. So the next part is, I'm going to put a wee bit of greenery up here, so treetops or a dark green here. Now, if you don't have a green as dark as that, you can always add just a wee tiny spot of black to it. And it's the same again if you're going to be lightening your green. just add it to some weight. Can do is once I would have used a little bit better, tissue paper and just kind of dab some areas in it and it'll lighten it. It gives you a wee bit of texture. Now, what I'm going to be doing next is a bit of light green on top of it. Now, you can either add a bit of yellow to it or a bit of white. Experiment a wee bit and see what you prefer. I'm just going to put a wee bit of yellow through mine, and it's like a kind of lime green then. So, and it's just kind of wee brightens the areas of the If we go back to this brush again, dip it into some yellow, just the very, very tip of there, and put wee tiny highlights there. And dab them in so that what will happen is they become green the more you tap in, just very gently though. I'm not wanting bright yellow, but it will tone down the more you tap in there. And it gives you a nice wee bit of kind of texture look. Now, we've got loads and loads of white down here, and there's a reason for that. What this is going to be, do you know, it's like a waterfall. It's all kind of like troughs up, and it's just all foamy. That's what we're going to try and achieve here. Just using this brush, dabbing it on very, very lightly. For the next part, we're going to just be repeating the same idea of what we've done up here, and we're going to put a wee bit of greenery down here. So, you can be quite quick with this because if it's patchy, that's fine because it's. I'm not wanting a solid colour there. It just doesn't look natural. So dabbing on is great. Then get a wee bit of yellow and just kind of lighten the certain areas of dabbing again. Now, I'm going to get my brush, the kind of bristly brush we've already worked with. The one that we were creating the foam for off. Now, what I'm doing is, it doesn't matter if this is still wet down here, because I'm just dabbing it on very, very gently, so it should sit and it shouldn't sink in there. Now, again, some yellow, and just very, very softly, just to be kind of yellow highlights. Now, what I want to do is wipe my brush, get all the yellow off it, and just keep on dabbing in it very gently, and it'll start to tone it down a wee bit. So I've took off the masking tape. Let's see. That is me finished. Now, that was a and seen how they're going. I think that the painting's only going to take 20 minutes because the video lasts 10, 20 minutes. I've posed this quite a lot and there's obviously a trying to take into consideration as well. So I'm thinking between maybe an hour and 2 hours should be get yourself to complete this painting. And once you've watched the video and if there's anything at all you want to ask, just leave a comment and I'll get back to you.